I need the right audience. Wait a minute. I'm looking for entrepreneurs, man. You got business people out there? This is Wes Point. Wes Point Podcast is a brand new show. Listen, if you're about money, if you're about investment, if you're about making some power move and getting your life changed up, well, this is your show. Welcome to the Wes Point Podcast Show, all right? It's going to be daily. It's going to be weekly. It's going to be monthly. You're going to see me everywhere, all right? Welcome. You guys probably don't know me. But my name is Wes.
Wes.
And this is my partner and co-founder of our companies. We have rest of my ads on this radio. Mm-hmm. Our company name is
Life Designers.
We do credit consultations, financial consultations. And reason why we had Envy do one of our commercials, because he's very involved in the community and he's doing certain things that we like. I think as far as when it comes to real estate, investments, and he's really inspiring people, and even me. So mm-hmm. I like that.
Love.
Thanks.
All right. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I have some questions for all of you guys. I have a podcast that I have, you know, and I want to get some footage of this. So it's a blessing. So with Envy, you know, I would like for you to think back, you know, 5-6 years ago, did you envision this would be possible where you are now with the show?
With the show, no, I didn't expect this with the show. I really didn't know what to expect. I was fine with afternoons. I mean, I was doing afternoons and I was happy. It was cool. It was good. I was happy. When they came with the idea of doing a morning show, I really didn't want to do it. Mm. I didn't want to work with Chalamagne.
Tell me why.
He got fired like 3-4 times before that. And at the time,
he's
I had
like,
two kids.
No one wants to work with Chalamagne.
No. I mean, he's a pleasure to work with. But back then, I was scared. I didn't want to work with Angela Yee. She was serious. And I thought that she didn't know the difference of cursing. Because I was like, because you're so used to cursing. Right. Say what you want.
You weren't serious.
I know, but I started with terrestrial radio.
That's hypocritical.
And I thought that I could get fired. I was like, Charlamagne saying some off the wall stuff and Angelique cursing, I won't be here long. I'll lose my job and then it'll be over. But they put us together and, you know, we work well with each other. I mean, everybody plays their position, plays their part. But I never would have expected over 90 markets, us doing this for 9 years, going on our 10th year, doing some of the things that we've done, from raising money to talking to schools to me doing real estate, E and I owning a juice bar, Charlamagne doing
awesome.
His books. If I would have never seen that in a million years.
Wow. So a lot of opportunities came about with the establishment of the show. You know, since back then, you guys never even foresee the future, but, you know, you guys are here now.
I saw it.
You saw it?
Absolutely. I told everybody we were going to be a nationally syndicated show and we was going to run the radio game. Because the only reason I knew that is because, like, everything is generational, right? Like, you know, Michael Jordan isn't going to play forever. Eventually, it's going to be a LeBron James. Right. It's like LeBron's not going to play forever. Eventually, it's going to be the next guy. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like the law of nature said somebody had to be, you know, one of the new kings and queens of that morning radio thing. So mm-hmm. I always saw that for us since day one.
Do you think that that's important, the confidence you had back then?
I think it's important to recognize your visions, good or bad. You know what I'm saying? Like you can... you know, not see something mm-hmm. and be wrong about it, and you can see something and be right about it. Or you can still see something, acknowledge it, and it still might not work out the way you wanted it to, but something may work out from just having that vision. So I think you should always, you know, try at least to see what the outcome could be for a situation.
So speaking of you, Charlamagne, tell me a recent setback and how you guys recovered within the show. Was there ever like
within
a setback?
The show?
Oh, something that happened?
Yeah, we lost our producer, you know what I'm saying? Our guy Q, who had been with us since day one.
What happened to him?
I mean, it's nothing tragic.
Nothing tragic.
He went to cooking school. He wanted to really pursue that dream. He always had to be a chef.
So he wanted to be in the culinary world. But I mean, that was a major setback because he literally started with us from day one. How long was he with us? 4 or 5 years?
Mm-hmm.
6 years. Mm-hmm. So we're going on year 9. So, you know, when you have that kind of trust in a person and, you know, you've built something, when you bring in, you know, a new production regime, it's going to be a lot of challenges, you know what I'm saying? Because you're growing with somebody new. But I think one thing that you have to do is stop comparing what you have now to what you had. Yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying? I think that when you have those kind of expectations, you'll always feel let down in a sense. So appreciate the new regime for what they are and what their skill set is. And I mean, I think we've overcome that.
Yep.
I think so. Nice. We made one bad decision, but you know, we corrected that. You know, we was content. We should have been content with the production team we had.
Right.
You know.
And Angelie, how did you build the skill always speaking so engagingly in front of others? You know, I love the way you speak.
I still
like flirting,
get
bro.
Really nervous talking in front of. I still do get really nervous talking in front of people, but I think what was hard for me to make that transition when I started in radio as Sirius, it wasn't like it is today with cameras rolling and people seeing you and having to do all of that. So it has still been a process for me. And then coming here, and then now where I'm on Revolt TV in the morning, everything's on camera, everything's on YouTube, and that has never been my intention. But I think it's important to get more comfortable just being able to speak. And I think being comfortable with what you're speaking about
mm-hmm.
also really helps
knowledge,
a lot. Even just being prepared, that helps me a lot. When I know I have myself together, I know what the topics are, I have some idea of where I want to go with it, I have an outline of what I want to make sure I address. It just helps me to be organized, and that helps me be more comfortable.
Okay. Yeah, we're doing a launch for our company next month in Atlanta. We're going to be speaking in front of a bunch of people.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess, yeah, it goes back to, you know, being prepared, knowing your material, knowing the stuff you need to talk about.
Yeah, nothing makes you more nervous than when you're late, you're not feeling put together, then you have to get up and talk, and you're like, what am I even talking about? What's
right,
happening?
Right, right.
So when you are more calm, when you get there early, when everything is in order, that definitely makes you feel comfortable.
And I want to go back to Envy. In your business, you know, I don't know if you are thinking credit, if you are dealing with individuals that that you're trying to do business with that don't have credit, that needs credit. But tell me, is there any stoppage for your business when it comes to credit?
Is there any what?
Is there anything that's stopping you from moving forward when it comes to credit?
In my business, in myself, I have great credit, so nothing stops me. But I mean, anybody out there that's trying to conduct business or trying to do anything, if it's real estate, they're trying to get a loan. I mean, credit matters. The higher your credit, the lower, you know, interest rate you're gonna have. To the point where some banks won't even give you a loan because of your credit. So, I mean, credit is, as far as investment in my, on my side of things, and what I'm doing is, you know, 90% of the deal. You know, that's where it starts. You know, first is the credit. Then after the credit, then you got to get your mortgage commitment, or you got to secure your lending,
mm-hmm.
whether it's hard money or whether it's conventional, and then finding a property and then investments. But yeah, credit is everything in my business.
I'd like to get a sense of what you guys think as far as the opportunities that we have in our community when it comes to credit. No one's really talking about it. But I know nowadays, though, there's a lot of people waking up to, like, I need to fix my credit. You know, credit is changing people's lives and everything. And Chalamagne, do you have abilities that you may want to bring forward when it comes to credit and maybe empowering the people?
Oh, he's in 800 Club.
Yeah, I got 809.
809 credit score?
Yeah, and you know, that's big for me because it was a point in my life where I had no credit. Mm. You know what I'm saying? And you know, you go and realize, like, damn, I don't have any credit mm-hmm. whatsoever. So back in the day, I got a secured debit card.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and like the secured debit card is what just helped me to establish, you know, phenomenal credit. And it's one of those things that I wasn't even paying attention to. I'm right. just the type of person
people,
I like to
most pay, people don't pay attention to it.
Yeah, yeah. I just like to pay my bills on time, and I really don't like to owe anybody. Like right. that's my pet peeve. So I'm the type of person to be like, if I got it, I'd rather just pay it in full instead of, like, you know, paying in portions, except for my Verizon bill. Like, I'll never pay that in full. Always pay the past due on that.
Okay.
But great. For whatever reason, I've been able to establish an 809, so I'm happy with that.
That's awesome, man. And I want, you know, if you guys can just keep talking about credit, you know, to the community, that'd be great, because a lot of us, it seems like we're like 1,000 years behind when it comes to credit.
Absolutely.
And I would like to bring our people up to speed. And I think you guys being in the space that you are in, it'd be incredible for you guys to, you know, to showcase that a little bit more. But I thank you guys for the time.
Well, thank you, brother.
This is Wes Point Podcast.
Awesome.
But thank you guys for having us here. I appreciate you.
Thank you, y'all, man. Appreciate
thank you, guys.
You.
Pleasure.